Emmy. If you're new to the channel, welcome. My name is Emmy. I'm a nutritionist and the creator of the Slim on Starch program, where my clients lose anywhere from the last 5 pounds to up to 70 pounds. And if you want to learn exactly how we do it, I'm actually holding a free training on the 5th and the 6th of January online. You can choose which date you want to go to so that you can learn the exact process that I take my clients through so that you as well can follow that process and can lose the weight on a plant-based diet. The link is in the description bar for that. Make sure that you sign up for that and that you also click subscribe so that you can be a healthy honey and be notified by turning on the notification bell. The notification bell. I messed up my words a little bit on that. Every time I upload a new video every Wednesday and Saturday with the hottest plant-based weight loss news. In this video, I'm interviewing Dr. Frank Sabatino. This is part 2 of the Dr. Frank video series because our interview was just so amazing and so packed with information. So if you haven't seen part 1 and you want to check it out, you can check it out down below. I will link it down there. But in this video, we are going to be talking about hormonal imbalances and what we actually mean by hormonal imbalances when it comes to weight loss, whether food, exercise, sleep, stress, which one of these is the most important when it comes to weight loss? How does stress affect weight loss? And then finally, is eating late at night bad for us if we want to lose weight? So if you want to learn those things, keep watching. So first I wanted to know, food, exercise, sleep, stress, which one of these is the most important and should we focus on the most when we're trying to lose weight? What I really appreciate about Dr. Frank is that he has such a holistic approach to health and weight loss, and he doesn't just focus on one thing, but he really looks at everybody that he works with as an individual person and looks at all of the facets of the lifestyle. And he really works with focusing on de-stressing and sleep and takes this holistic approach that has fabulous results. So I wanted to know, Dr. Frank, if you had to pinpoint one of these that's the most important, what would that be? I've always said food is king. Food is number one. Get the food right first. Hold off on your gym membership. Just hold the phone. Let's get the food right first. Does he agree?
Well, you know what? I think it all starts with the food. Let's be realistic, because we're eating every day. You know what I mean? And so I think, it's all about the food in many ways. And so for me, I think working off of that low calorie dense model that is provided for by plant-based eating is the starting point. And I think that needs to be the starting point. And I think once you start there, even with modest activity and stuff, you start to see dramatic changes in well-being and so on, and even weight loss. And I really feel that that's something that provokes you to look in and work with the other pieces. Do you know what I'm saying? So I really think it's all about the food, and I like to see people start with that piece of going into plant-based eating. Because if you do, you already are starting to balance most of the hormones that we've talked about. You're already starting to balance the body's sleeping pattern to some degree. So you're already starting to balance many things that need to be addressed. But by just eating in the way we're recommending, it already starts to get that ball really going. So it's not that it's only the food, but the food is a huge piece and the starting point for me, for sure.
So Dr. Frank says what Dr. McDougall always says, which is it's the food. Food really is king and is the most important thing. I have a client, Sarah, who's lost over 70 pounds, and the exercise that she did every day was that she walked a kilometer to the train for work every day, and that was her exercise to lose 70 pounds. Food is the most important thing, and all she did was change her diet, and that's how she got these tremendous results. Food, food, food. Focus on the food first. And if you're not sure what I mean by food, you know, what am I supposed to eat? You say focus on the food, but I don't know what to eat. Then get my grocery list in the down bar. So next I wanted to ask Dr. Frank, what do we mean when we say hormonal imbalances? We always hear people saying, my hormones are out of whack, my hormones aren't balanced. But what does that actually mean? And what Dr. Frank says is super insightful, because we just learned that the food is the most important, but it's not the only thing that is important. There are so many other factors that determine weight loss, as we'll hear about right now.
The fact of the matter is you've got a whole series of hormones. You've got a hormonal system, an endocrine system, that is constantly trying to balance itself, and it doesn't operate in isolation. your hormonal system is interacting with your immune system, which is interacting with your nervous system. So all the systems of the body are no longer seen as separate. There was a time when everybody learned them as separate. We now know they work together in the mind-body connection. But the fact of the matter is there are certain hormones. We mentioned a major one, which is insulin. So the biggest problem with weight loss is insulin resistance. If you want to nail a hormone, but think about this. If you're dealing with stress, and the stress can even be chemical stress from eating too much sugar or garbage in the diet, you're going to have a release of cortisol from the adrenal gland. So the adrenal hormones will also play a role on weight gain. Cortisol will promote abdominal weight gain, belly weight gain. So many times, if you just look at two hormones, something as simple as adrenal and insulin resistance, that can be a big piece. And the third area that's very big for that is going to be the thyroid gland, which is involved in metabolism. So if you look at the interaction between pancreas, thyroid, adrenal, the brain, and you look at how that interaction is going, yeah, there's going to be imbalances for people with weight issues. But the truth is, as soon as they start regulating that dietary plan, as soon as they start moving more effectively, as soon as they start understanding the impact of stress and sleep on all of that, they have remarkable recovery with weight patterns. The problem is they're not necessarily making the right commitment, or they're only looking at food and then they go into extreme dietary approaches rather than understanding that they have to foster a kind of balance between these systems. So you could use the word weakly and just say hormones, my hormones are the problem. But when you really look at it, the hormones are not the problem. The body's just releasing and adjusting hormones around a lifestyle that has made it impossible for the system to function in balance. The hormones are not the problem. The person is the problem. Once you start creating the right conditions, the hormones, the body heals. We have this notion that the hormonal system doesn't heal, but it does. But many times it gets established at a certain set point. And then if you change, that new set point has to have some time to regulate. That's why effectively weight loss effectively is over the course of months and years, not weeks. And so you've got to understand that that's what's going to happen. And you need to hold your ground during that time. And that's the hard part. Because, you know, it's hard to stay in your life always connected, but in a way you've got to stay focused.
As Dr. Frank says here, all of the systems in our body are interconnected. Our hormonal system affects our nervous system, which affects our immune system. It's like this domino effect. And we so often pinpoint one of these things as being wrong, like my hormones are out of balance, so I'm broken. When really all of these things are interconnected, and we have to focus on all of the other systems within our body to become healthy overall. We can't just focus on one thing. It's not just one thing that's the issue, but really everything plays off of one another. So by making lifestyle changes that positively affect the other systems in our body, we can promote weight loss and promote health. And this is why we have Coach Kiki on the Slim on Starch program to help you with those mindset changes, like de-stressing, allowing yourself to go to bed early and get more sleep so that you can positively affect your weight loss. Because there are so many other factors at play that we have to consider aside from food and exercise. Yes. Food is the most important, but there's a lot more for us to consider here. And I've seen people that are eating perfectly, and they really are eating perfectly, but they're overeating. They're stuffing themselves to the brim. They're using food to cope. They're not getting enough sleep. They're stressed. And for those reasons, they won't experience the weight loss. And that's why I hired Coach Kiki to come onto the program so that we can not just look at the food. We have a registered dietitian that looks at everything you eat to make sure that you are getting the food right. But then we have Coach Kiki to help you make sure you're getting the lifestyle right. So we know that there are so many factors that affect weight loss, and stress is one of those factors. So I had Dr. Frank tell us, how does stress affect weight loss?
Well, that's what we're talking about. So you've got to get that in touch. That's why when I do my weight loss program, I cover all of those pieces. And I do whole programs just on stress management and the sleep dynamic, because it is a piece and it is an issue. And the stress component drives, again, a level of hormonal imbalance on adrenal and thyroid that makes weight loss more and more difficult. And so when you go into the normal cycle of stress, you go into three phases. It's called an adaptation response. You have alarm, where you're first encountering stress. Then you have resistance, where you have to resist that stress if it continues. And finally, if the stress goes on long enough and you're no longer able to resist, you go into exhaustion. Body gets exhausted. When the body gets exhausted, the glands that have been helping you resist, adrenal, thyroid, they get exhausted. And when they get exhausted and run down, you're no longer able to be effective in metabolizing anything. So it's harder to lose weight. It's harder to keep it off, even when you're eating well. And so that's why I tell people, you have to understand that stress and sleep are as much, stress management or stress recovery are as and sleep are as much a part of your weight loss program as the food and everything else you're doing. You got to understand that. And if you do, you pick up on some very major missing links. These are big missing links in the weight loss story.
So like we've been talking about, yes, food is the most important thing when it comes to weight loss, but there are so many other factors for us to consider, like stress. Stress negatively affects our adrenals and our thyroid, and when we push ourselves to the level of exhaustion, our adrenal and our thyroid aren't able to metabolize anything. This is why de-stressing is so important, and you can be eating perfectly and going to the gym every single day, but if you're stressed beyond belief, it can undo all of the hard work that you're doing. So clearly, our lifestyle has a huge impact on our weight loss. And so I wanted to ask Dr. Frank the question that is debated about every single day and every person has a different opinion on, which is eating late at night bad for weight loss? Now, I eat most of my calories later in the day, and I have not had any negative effects from eating later at night. And many of my clients eat right before bed, and we haven't seen any negative effects. But I still wanted to get his input on it, because I'm always open to learning what studies show and to learning new things. And I always, always, always want to encourage you guys to not just do something because somebody says that you should do it, or just because a study shows something. I think it's a great way to experiment with your lifestyle, but not to determine your lifestyle. So go ahead and experiment with these things and listen to what Dr. Frank says and perhaps implement it in your life, but don't just do it because somebody's telling you to do it and you're not getting results from it. If you get great results from something, then keep doing what you're doing. And if you don't need to change anything, then don't change anything. But if you're not getting the desired results that you're looking for, then perhaps what you're about to hear might help you out. And also, I'm curious, what time do you guys take your last bite of food? Leave a comment. I really want to know, what time do you take your last bite of food?
Well, if you really look at human beings, you know, I love when people say I'm a night person. There are no night people. The truth of the matter is we are diurnal animals. We are actually designed to be very active, eating, functioning in daylight. And as we come into nighttime hours, we're supposed to be winding down toward rest and sleep. So the evening hours to me are not the times to eat and be active. That's one of the reasons why I like intermittent fasting, because it tends to work off the idea of creating nighttime hours where there's no food consumption at all. The observation is that people who don't eat at night typically lose weight faster, lose weight better, and have better hormonal regulation. The more you eat at night, the more you disturb everything. So if you are going to eat at night, I would eat in the early night hours and eat very light in the evening hours. And certainly no alcohol, coffee, anything like that in those hours, because we're really designed to eat very little at night, and we're really designed to exercise very little at night. We're supposed to be winding down to take advantage of those night hours to actually feed and balance metabolism and to do the things that have to happen in sleep, in repair and growth from the daylight hours. So I would say yes, the factors of when you take calories are as important in some ways as the calories that you're taking. The problem is we're not designed to spend all that digestive energy. The cells are still working in nighttime hours. They're processing. They're detoxifying, they're doing a lot. But the fact of the matter is we need that pattern of winding down. The same way the day winds down, we need to wind down. See, we've become so divorced from natural rhythms of nature And the truth of the matter is, if we follow that pattern more, and of course our culture, it's very difficult because we got so much going on and so much things going on at nighttime for people. But the truth is, the more you can get in touch with the natural rhythm of things in your whole life, not just eating, the better off we all are. That's why the better hours for sleep are about 10 in the nighttime till about 4 or 5 in the morning. Those are primo night hours for deep delta wave sleep. The wave of sleep that really promotes effective weight loss and better hormonal balance. So I think you'll find everything balances better when you can respect the light-dark cycle a little bit more effectively. The more you disturb that rhythm of the light-dark cycle, and we look at shift work as our classic example, and the more you have sleep deficiency that happens, the more the hormonal changes favor reactive fat and weight gain. I mean, there's huge, numerous, ungodly numbers of studies all over the place that are really good quality studies. The truth of the matter is, the more that you respect the idea that eating less at night and working more toward winding down and improving your sleep pattern, you will have the greatest success with weight loss. There's no question in my mind. I've watched it for 40 years. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's just the way it is. And I urge people, if you don't believe that, just do it. Just try it in your life. Go on a little period where even if you do a 12-12 cycle with intermittent fasting, just take those 8 to 12 hours of nighttime hours without any eating pattern at all. Usually you'll have less pain when you wake up in the morning. Your weight loss will be better. Your hormonal balance will be better. Your craving will be less. All of that will change.
So once again, Dr. Frank ties this back to all of our systems working together, and he really enforces us to be in rhythm with all of the systems that are going on inside of our body and all the systems in the universe. So to align our body and our rhythms with the rhythm of the sunrise and the sunset and get everything working together so that we can be working at our optimal way that we were designed so that humans can operate the way that humans were designed to operate. Now, like I said, I haven't had any issues from eating late at night, but if you are not losing weight and you're doing everything quote unquote perfectly, but you're eating late at night, perhaps you want to shift your calories earlier in the day. I will say that eating late at night, I often see is associated with stress. It's a stress eating mechanism. A coping mechanism, or if you are up late for work and you're stressed and you're just eating more calories. A lot of people eating late at night are just eating more calories throughout the course of the day because they're up late and eating more calories, or it's associated with restricting during the day and then binging out at night. So there's a lot of, is it correlation, is it causation type of thing? But nevertheless, I think that it's important that you experiment if things aren't working for you and find what does work for you. Make sure you give this video a like and you share it with somebody that would find it useful, and make sure that you sign up for the free training that I'm holding on the 5th and the 6th of January so that you can kickstart 2020. It's totally free. You can kickstart 2020 and we can make this truly the roaring 20s. You're gonna lose the weight this year. I got you, honey. Don't worry. I love you guys and I'll see you in my next video. Woo!